So today we're going on a submarine trip. I cannot wait to actually go. I've never been on one. It's something that I've always found fascinated, but never actually bothered to look, whatever. But fingers crossed it's going to be great. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to film or take pictures. I will ask, and if I do, be right after this clip.
On an ordinary tank of air, and if he has to go any deeper, for every tank he goes, that air is going to have to be specially mixed to accommodate that depth. And time is viable during an emergency, so if you do need to make an emergency ascent, you're going to need a diver. 150 feet would be the safest depth for him on an ordinary tank of air. Down to 114 feet, if you look, oh, and down, you should be seeing the ocean floor at this point. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Great, wonderful. That has brought us to the end of our tour. Thank you very much. Now here we have a wreck, ladies and gents. And this is not the Titanic, okay? We're in the tropics. This is the Lord of Willoughby, and it was given to a group of recreational divers a few years ago. Now it used to be a freshwater carrying barge, which was being used before we had our Miami Harbor. But then we were using the natural harbor known as Carlisle Bay. Some of you might know that area as Bronze Beach. Carlisle Bay is a relatively shallow area, so what would have happened back then is that the larger vessels would have left around a mile or so off the island, but the smaller ones like this one here would have ferried all the cargo and people to and from our shores during that period. Right, basically became obsolete after our Miami Harbor was completed in 1961, so